We're back with our groceries table, but we've expanded on it a bit. It now has a column for which aisle number we can find the item at the supermarket, plus we've added a few more items. Now you can really see the power of SQL in different ways that you can retrieve data from your database. And this is also where it can get a bit tricky. To start off simple, how would we retrieve all the rows from our table? To perform any query, we write select, and then which columns we're interested in, like the name, and then from, and the table name that we're selecting from. And we can see a list of the groceries on the right under that results section. But what if we want all of the column names? We can just replace name with star. And that was also the query that got inserted when you click the table name, which you might remember from the first talk through. This list is out of order though. If we went from top to bottom at the store with this list, we'd have to keep changing aisles. We'd rather have it ordered by aisle so that we can be more efficient at the store. To do that, we can just add an order by clause to our query, specifying which column we want to order by. Ah, that's better. Now we can get our ingredients faster. But to be even more efficient, my brother and I like to shop together and split the store so that I shop in half the store, he shops in the other half, and we meet at the checkout. There are 12 aisles at this grocery store, so for my list, I just want to know which items are in aisles 6 through 12. Well, anytime we want to filter results out, we can use a where clause for this and specify the column name and then what we want to compare it to. So in this case, I used a greater than operator, but there's lots of different comparison operators depending on what it is we're trying to filter by. Great. So now I know exactly what items I'm going to get. I'm going to be really efficient. And you've learned a few ways to use SQL to query. Now stay tuned to find out even more ways that you can select.